Hello everyone, welcome to new video. Today we are going to discuss about new phenomenon, second phenomenon of our chapter, that is dissociation of ion. Dissociations of ion. Previously we have studied ionic compound. In that we have studied that each and every component has their ionic means ionic electronic configuration around in it. So today we are going to discuss about decomposition of or dissociation of ion. What is meant by dissociation? Dissociation is nothing but the displacement. What is meant by displacement? When concentrated is converted into dilute. For example, if you have taken a HCl, HCl is an example of acid. If you have taken a HCl in a beaker which is full of water, the beaker should be full of water. So what exactly happens when you add this HCl into the container? What exactly happens, beta? This HCl forms and precipitate. HCl, when we drop HCl in the water, so what exactly happens? The ion of water molecule. Ion of means ions which are of water molecule, because we know very well H2O, which means H positive and O negative. There are also two ions which are formed in the water contaminant, means water. So in the water droplets. So that's the reason the molecules of water in which ion is present, that ion displaces these molecule of HCl to dissociate with respect to water. Dissociate with respect to water. And here we get the combined product, that is where we have taken here concentrated. So dilute HCl should be appears over here, which is plus water H2O. So this is nothing but the dissociation, in which what happened, beta? That the concentric HCl, H plus Cl minus ion, get dissociate with respect to water, because the ion which are present in the water start displacing these ion which are HCl, having the electronic HCl. So when this ion get displaced, at that time decomposition take place. This is nothing but the decomposition of ion. Best example for it, another examples also you can take, that is first one you can take water plus salt, in which what happen, it forms a salt water. Okay, it forms a salt water. You will take water plus sugar, become sugar water or sweet water. Okay, so these are nothing but the dissociation. What exactly happened? The concentrating, if you take the 1 gram of sugar, 1 gram of salt, and you directly have in it or have taken a bite of it, so you'll feel a strong test of it. But when you add these 1 gram of water in 1 liter of water, so the test might be get less. What happened, beta? In that, just it dissociate their ions with respect to another one. That is known as dissociation of ion. Now the second point is nothing but the Arrhenius theory. What is meant by Arrhenius theory? Arrhenius is the name of the scientist who has invented his theory in the branch of chemistry, especially in acid and bases. Okay, so what is meant by Arrhenius theory? Arrhenius theory. What is the Arrhenius theory? Arrhenius theory of acid and base. Arrhenius, the name of scientist is Arrhenius. Arrhenius state that when you take a component or when you take an liquid, that not water only, whatever substance you have taken. Suppose we have taken HCl. The substance that we have taken over here is HCl. So HCl we can consider over here the example to represent its value. Okay, so when you decompose it or dissociate it, so we'll got here H plus ion and Cl minus ion. Okay, same if you take NaOH, so here what exactly happened? Na positive and OH negative. Okay, positive positive, negative negative, ions you got. What Arrhenius theory said, that whenever you took an example, that is HCl, H2SO4, sulfuric acid. When you sulfuric acid react with the water, react with water. So what exactly happens? H plus ion should be separated from it, and again HSO4 ion should be separated from it, becomes H2O. When HCl react with water, when HCl react with water, H plus ion and Cl minus ion also get separated. Second example, HSO4, in which what happened? When it again react with water, so H plus plus SO4 minus, that type of ion you got. The substance, from this calculation we can clearly instantly say that this calculation in which I just remove this and just add this one. Now the second one is this is the first one. The second one, he has taken NaOH, as I have previously taken upside. NaOH which react with the water gives Na plus ion and OH minus, or here I'll shift, add the word plus here. Okay, next, another we have taken CaOH twice, which is solid in state, when again react with water gives Ca2 plus, means calcium having two pluses, because Cl2, Ca2, because of that only we have written here plus 2, and twice OH minus ion we got here. Okay, so this is nothing but the Arrhenius theory. From here what you have conducted, see this beta, Arrhenius theory state that the substance undergoes a reaction and gives H plus ion in the reaction is called acids. Okay, and the substance here, what we can see, OH minus, OH minus, here H plus, H plus, H plus. So how we can make this definition? The substance undergoes a reaction and gives OH minus ion in the reaction called base. That is the Arrhenius theory. What Arrhenius theory state that beta? The substance after reaction gives H plus ion called acids, and the substance after reaction gives OH minus ion called base. So that is the Arrhenius theory. Arrhenius theory state that acid and base. On the basis of that, Arrhenius has again classified these acids into two components, that is strong acid and weak acid. Strong acid and weak acid. What is meant by strong acid? In the reaction which gives more H plus ion, in the reaction gives more H plus ion called strong acid. We can take here example of strong acid is, that is HCl, H2SO4, HBr, because after reaction this H gives more H plus ion. And for weak acid, see, what is the definition of weak acid? In the reaction which gives less H plus ion called weak base. Okay, next, examples of weak base is H2CO3, next citric acid CH3COOH, citric acid which we get from the lemon. Okay, these are the weak acid, that's the reason we can eat it. But if by mistakenly HCl falls on our body or our any skin part, or our skin part get directly contact with the HCl HBr, so it might be get burned. So that's why students, the reaction in which means concentrated acid were not given for the students. Some of the students were asking continuously to me, sir, why we were not able to do the calculations or do the reactions with the strong acid or strong base, why we get the least और लेस स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड एंड वीक एसिड एंड वीक बेस. वाई सो बेटा? बिकॉज ऑफ दैट रीजन ओनली, बिकॉज स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड्स गेट कॉन्टैक्ट विथ योर स्किन, सो योर स्किन माइट बीन गेट डैमेज और इट विल बी गेट बर्नड. दैट्स द रीजन वी आर यूज हियर वीक एसिड्स, मीन्स डायल्यूट एसिड्स फॉर यू ओनली. अप टू वेन एवर यू आर डूइंग योर पी जी पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन, एट द टाइम यू विल हैव टू टैकल विथ द कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड ओनली. बट अप टू योर एज सो माइट बीन इट कंसिडर दैट यू हैव टू practice with the weak acids only. So now this is about weak acid. For weak base, how we'll make the definition, for weak base? For that, okay, I'll reduce it. Afterwards, what happened, beta? See, in the acids we said that the gives more H plus ion called strong acids, less H plus ions called weak acids. More OH minus ion called strong base, less OH minus called weak base. See beta, how means tricky it was to learn or to memorize it. So it was so easy to learn or memorize. The substance which gives more H plus, strong acid, less CH plus, weak acids. More OH minus, strong base, less OH minus, weak base. So how will you define it for weak base? Weak base is nothing but the means a base which gives less OH minus ion in the reaction called weak base. So examples of weak base is NaH4OH, NH4OH, okay, NH4OH. Next, strong base. What is meant by strong base? A base which gives more OH minus ions in the reaction called strong base. So examples of strong base is NaOH, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, CaOH2 twice, and Na2O. These are the examples of strong base. So this is nothing but the strong acid and strong base. Now afterwards, one more point is there, that is alkali. What is meant by alkali? So as we have seen over here, so firstly we have seen dissociation. What is meant by dissociation? In reaction, the molecules or the ion get separated from the material and the concentrated material converted into dilute one. That is called as dissociation. Afterwards, we have seen the Arrhenius theory. What Arrhenius theory said? That H plus ion, the reaction in which we get H plus ion called acids, and the reaction in which we get OH minus ion called base. Afterwards, we have seen the classification of acid and base. Acids are classified into further two types, that is strong acid and weak acid. What is meant by strong acid? The acid in which we get the more H plus ion called strong acid, and the reaction in which we get less H plus ion called weak acids. And for the base, the reaction in which we get more OH minus ion called strong base, and the reaction in which we get less OH minus ion called weak base. So afterwards, third one is also there, that is also known as alkali. What is meant by alkali? So alkali means, alkali is nothing but the, sorry, one minute. Alkali, what is meant by alkali? The base which are highly soluble in water, soluble in water is called alkali, because most of the acids get dissolved in water, but the most of base will not get dissolved in water. Some amount of precipitate, PPT, should be remains in the reaction. So some of their which are directly means they are directly totally soluble in water, examples of it is KOH, NH4, next NH3, next NaOH, next KOH, that earlier we have taken. Afterwards is, means these are, here NaOH and means N, if you have seen KOH and NaOH, so these are strong as alkalis. These are strong alkalis. And NH3 is weak alkali. How we can see this strong? Because KOH and NaOH are strong base and NH3 is weak base. That's the reason it is called as weak alkali and this is called as strong alkali. So these are nothing but the alkali. So afterwards we have a basicity and acidity. What is meant by basicity and what is meant by acidity? So here, student, first of all we are going to discuss about basicity. Basicity of acids. What is meant by basicity of acids? The number of H plus ion obtained by a dissociation of one molecule of acids is called its basicity. And for acidity or base, so the number of OH minus ion, same as it is, the number of ion obtained by dissociation of one molecule of base is called its basicity. एक मॉलिक्यूल से जब एच सी एल लिया हमने, फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव टेकन एच सी एल, अनदर एग्जाम्पल वट एवर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव टेकन, सो द वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ एच सी एल गिवस हाउ मेनी एच प्लस आयन इन द रिएक्शन, दैट इज नोन एज बेसिसिटी ऑफ एसिड्स. एंड वॉट इज मीन बाय एसिडिटी? फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू हैव टेकन ए के ओ एच, सो नंबर ऑफ के ओ एच यू आर ऑप्टेन फ्रॉम वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ के ओ एच, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज basicity. So student, that is all about basicity and acidity. Next in the next video module we are going to discuss about concentration of acids and base, why it is important, and as previously I told you, these are important concept to me. Next, so for this you have to subscribe the channel, because whenever I'll upload the video you will get the notification. To get that notification you will have to subscribe the channel and turn on the bell notification to all. I hope you understand this phenomenon. Regarding to this phenomenon, if you have any doubts, so don't forget to ask in the comment box which is given below. And I hope you enjoy this phenomenon. Thanks for the watching. Thank you.